Hi, I'm Sandy Munns, Fire Behavior Analyst here on the Dixie Fire.
Hi, I'm Ben Bartis, Incident Meteorologist here on the Dixie Fire. Sandy and I are here again to chat some fire weather and meteorology on the west zone of the Dixie Fire. Before that, I just wanted to touch on one thing. Sandy and I talked about fire behavior and weather and what that means for fire last time we were up here. I want to expound on that on the weather piece just a little bit. As an incident meteorologist, I'm specifically trained to come out and support wildland firefighting efforts. So I support firefighter safety, the plans of the fire, and as well as the public around the fire. We're a cadre of about 80 to 90 meteorologists that come out here. We have a training pipeline where we actually train with wildland firefighters. So we are specifically tailored to forecast weather for a fire. We're here to serve and we love what we do. So with that, let's turn to the weather. So past couple days we had this cold front sweep through the fire. It dropped a good amount of rain on the northern and western part of the fire, actually kind of right where we needed it. Got about a tenth to a quarter of an inch of rain across the northwest part of the fire. That pushed through. It exited early this morning completely, and now we have these northwest winds for the day and this nice kind of cool fall air behind it today. Just kind of a calmer weather day, a bit of a break. Tonight, however, we're going to see winds switch to the northeast coming across the fire, and these dry northeast winds coming out of the Great Basin will drop our relative humidities pretty quick, even with that rain we just got. So you'll see if you go to weather.gov that a bunch of fire or red flag warnings, as they're called, were issued for the Central Valley and west of us with those drying conditions. I don't think we're going to get that dry on the fire, so we don't have one for the Dixie itself, but just be aware that these next couple days we're going to see some northeasterly winds push across and really dry us out, and that's going to give us a good test here Monday and Tuesday. And after that, weather calms down for the rest of the week, and I'll pass it over to Sandy now for some fire behavior.
Okay, so how does this weather affect the fire itself? One of the primary things that we look at is how the moisture affects the fuels. What we do is we group fuels based on their size into a general category. We call them 1, 10, 100, and 1,000 hour fuels. Fine dead fuels like grasses and pine needles are the 1 hour fuels. They can change their moisture content significantly within 1 hour plus or minus. Larger twigs are about 10 hours. Larger sticks and big branches are closer to 100 plus or minus, and then big logs and heavy pieces of fuel, we call those 1,000 hour fuels. And we use those as an approximation as to how the fuel condition will change. So with a weather pattern like we just experienced, we got about 12 hours worth of moisture spread out over that 12 hour period. Much of the moisture will moisten up the fine fuels very quickly. They won't burn, but the heavier fuels, the 100 and 1,000 hour fuels, they take 4 days up to 40 days to absorb enough moisture. So rain like this will hit the fuels, run off into the surrounding soil, and it doesn't really affect the fire as much as you might think. It does dampen the fire intensity, and it causes it to smolder more rather than burn intensely. The advantage of that is we can get in and actually fight the fire more effectively. So this is a reprieve for us, allows us an opportunity to get into this fire area and hit it really hard and start getting good extinguishment and full containment of this fire. We had a couple of places right here in the middle of the fire, and then there were some heavy down dead materials up in the north end here. A couple of other spots elsewhere on the fire that we had concerns with. As with the moisture, those areas we're now able to get in there and get them extinguished very effectively. So the rain did help us, but it did not put the fire out. We're going to need a minimum of 3 days of continual precipitation to actually be a fire-ending event.